Hi students, today's topic is structure of tooth in human digestion absorption from 11th class. Here structure of tooth which in buccal cavity we know that different types of tooth are there. Here she starts with the one objective, find out the diaphyodont teeth. Find out the diaphyodont teeth. You know that we have four kinds of tooth are present. Based on that they ask here, absent one incisors, absent two canines, and option three premolars, four is both one and two. To solve this objective, we should know about complete structure of tooth and types of tooth, all the things. Now here see, human tooth which are under comes the first one, thecodont. First one is the thecodont type and second is the heterodont type. Last one is the diaphyodont. What they given here? Diaphyodont type. Here you see here, thecodont means the most percentage of tooth which is embedded into the jaw socket. That's the reason it's our mammal's tooth belongs to the thecodont type, which are the common especially. Right here, heterodont, it means in our lifetime, two times the tooth will be appear. And diaphyodont means here, heterodont means they have a different types. Right, four kinds of hetero means different, four kinds of tooth are present, that's why called as the R teeth belongs to the heterodont tooth. And here di means two times, which is a childhood. What the tooth we have, the teeth we have, they will be replaced by the permanent teeth. That's the reason diaphyodont R teeth are becomes the diaphyodont. Now objective related with the diaphyodont, it means you should know that before that how the structure of tooth and what are the types of tooth you have to learn here. See here, they have given 1, 2 and 3, 4th as a both 1 and 2. For that answer is the 1 and 2 because of find out the diaphyodont teeth which are the incisors and canines, both are diaphyodont teeth. Rest of the premolars and third set of molar, these are absent in the childhood. That's the reason these premolars and which is the third set of molar are not undergoes the diaphyodont. They one time only they will be formed and up to end will be there, which are the premolar and third set of molars. Now have to learn about the how to arrange teeth are arranged in our jaw sockets. This is the upper jaw, this is the lower jaw. See here, this is known as the teeth known as the maxillary teeth. This is known as the lower jaw, mandibulary. Mandibulary teeth. Maxillary teeth and mandibular teeth. Here we have four kinds. Hetero, I told you know, hetero means different. Four kinds of teeth are there. These are the IC, premolar and molar. ICPM. ICPM. These kinds are the incisors and canines and premolars and molars. These are the four kind of teeth present in our both jaws. Here if you see the maxillary teeth, same ICPM, incisors, canines, premolars and molars. In the lower jaw also same as these arrangement is there. See incisors, scissor means for the cutting purpose. These are the chisel in shape. These incisors are the chisel shape, they are useful for the cutting of food material. These are the dagger shaped teeth, which are the canines for the touring purpose. Mostly it's well developed in the carnivores, meat eating organisms. Premolars and molars, which are used for the grinding, and these are the chewing purpose. Both are grinding and mixing purpose and chewing purpose useful, which are the premolars and molars. This number in a human being, you know, the total number of tooth in human being, adult 32. These incisors number is 8 and canines are the 4, premolars 8 and molars are the 12. Total together 32 teeth present in human being. Now here see, half of these are the dental formula of adult tooth is the 2 1 2 3. It means 2 1 2 3. Right, here this shows the numerator and denominator. If you see that, this indicates the half of this jaw. Here this is the upper jaw half. How many there here? Incisors 2 and canines 1 and premolars 2 and molars are the 3. 2, 1, 2, 3 is the dental formula. Now here if you see, remaining half also as it is 2, 1, 2, 3. Now if you calculate here, 3 plus 2, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 plus 8, 16. 16 upper jaw have, in the lower jaw also same have 16. 16 plus 16, it have a 16 plus 16, it becomes the 32. 32 will come. So here, this is the dental formula of adult. If you take childhood dental formula, 2 by 2, 1 by 1, 0 by 0, 2 by 2. Right? This is the milk teeth or the primary teeth dental formula, which is the childhood. 2 by 2, 1 by 1, 0 by 0, 2 by 2. In the previous object, it can clearly explain here, these are the total 5 plus 5, 10, 10 into 2, 20. Childhood teeth are the milk teeth, dentation is the dental formula is the 20. So here, what are the tooth are absent here? ICPM. These premolars are absent, right? And actually this should be 3, but here also one pair of molar also absent, right? So that's the reason in the child below the 12 years is these premolars are absent, one more set of molars are absent. That's the reason these two are the not a diphyodont teeth. Rest of canines and incisors and canines and two set of molars we can consider as a diphyodont. Right? So here 20 tooth are present, 20 teeth are present in child. Whereas if you compare the below age 8, below age 8, they have nearly, means what you know, they have a, these will be 2 and these will be 1, and here premolars they have 2, 1, 2 and here 2 by 2. 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 4, 3 plus 4 are 7, 7, 14, 14 into 2, 28. For these below the age 18, the people does not have a third molar. That will be pure nearly 20 years at the DSS. That teeth known as the wisdom teeth. Wisdom teeth. What is it? Wisdom teeth. This is the age below the 18 and above the 12, 28. This is the dental formula. This is the adult dental formula. This is the childhood dental formula. Now here, if you go for the structure of tooth, here that most percentage of tooth is separated into the jaw socket. This teeth, tooth having the three parts, crown and neck and root. crown, neck and root. Crown, which is visible part outside, is the crown, which is mostly made up of the dentine. The dentine is covered by the enamel. Enamel is the strongest part in our body. Dentine is strong than the bone. Okay, so here the dentine, where it is now, that neck region where the gums or the gingiva are present, that's the neck area. And here alveolar process is there in that jaw socket, that is covered by the cementum, right? And which is the root is there, you know, that is supplied with the blood vessels and nerves. Now here see, enamel and dentine. Dentine is secreted from the special type of cells are there. The cells called as the odontoblast cells. Dentine secreted from the odontoblast cells. These are derived from the mesodermal origin. Got it? Dentine is the harder than the bone, which is the main composition of the bone or tooth, which is secreted from the odontoblast cells. The odontoblast cells are which are derived from the mesodermal origin. Next one, enamel. Enamel is the strongest part of body which covers the dentine. This is derived from the special type of cells. These known as the amyloblast cells. So here these are from the ectodermal origin. That's the reason human teeth derived from the both ectoderm and mesoderm. For the simple code is a dome. Just to remember, D-O-M, dome. D meant for the dentine, O meant for the odontoblast cells, M for the mesoderm. If you remember D-O-M, you can easily write dentine derived from the odontoblast cells of mesoderm. Rest of the amyloblast cells secretes the enamel, and this is the ectodermal origin, starts with the E and E, enamel. In such way, I have to remember that one. Right? So this is about that. And if you go for the remaining animals, monophyodont, this is the ephedon, you know. Monophyodont means what, you know? That organism which are the rodents, their lifetime only one time on that tooth will be appeared. There is no chance of again like a deciduous teeth and a permanent teeth in human life. There is a monophyodont, right? Now different animals dental formula. Now you have to learn about the rabbit dental formula.